Hello, I am Kevin with Rivalry, and I am here with the Nuxie. How you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you, Kevin?
Wonderful. We are here to find out a little bit about what you do. You are a workshop artist for Dota. Where have people maybe seen some of your work? You have some pieces that have made it through the workshop?
Oh yeah, of course. I've been making sets for Dota 2 since 2012. So my first one was Snowdrop, which was in the Polycount Winter Bundle. And then I've gotten heaps in since then, so maybe people would know the Dazzle Shadowflame,
Nice.
the Morana Albion, the Phantom Assassin for Eternal Envy,
Nice. When you
the one
say
that
you
looks
have,
really anime.
yeah, of course that fits him nicely. When you say you have heaps in, how many have made their way in? Like 5, 10, 50? Like, I have no idea.
Gosh, I did count the other day. Each item, not including sets. Oh God, I can't remember. It's over 15.
Okay. It's like 15, 20, something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
Nice. So, yeah, for people that don't know, what is the workshop and what's it all about? How does it kind of work from inception to getting into the hands of players?
Well, it starts off with an idea, as everything does, and that idea is usually really bad. And then you take the really bad idea and you just work through it and you concept it. And then eventually you have the bad idea turned into something usable. And then you can base your model off that. And it's a very organic, fluid, and frustrating process, but it gets the job done.
So do you end up throwing kind of a lot of your work away where you make it and you're just not happy with it and start over?
I never, well. Sometimes I've start over. I know some artists that are real perfectionists and they won't finish a piece until they've got it just right. But I like to finish a piece of work and then use the finished piece as my reference for what went wrong, what didn't go wrong, and what not to do in the future.
Sure.
Instead of like stopping halfway through and then going, oh, that was absolute crap. I'm gonna start again because it's super hard to. It's super hard to gauge like a work in progress, because it's not finished, so you don't actually know what the final result is going to
And
look like.
you're the only critic, right? Whereas if you get it out there, you have other feedback. Cool. So how does, I mean, for the actual process, then you design something, you have a template, you design it. What's the process? You submit to the workshop, it's public votes, private votes. Like, how does it actually get into the game?
Once I finish the model, we use the Dota 2 client, which is like the bug testing, oh no, the tools, the Dota 2 tools to upload the item to the workshop. And then once it's uploaded, we can just set it to public and people can then view it on the workshop. And people are supposed to vote on it on the workshop and then the ones with the highest votes Valve will look at, and then they'll have their internal team analyze the set and make sure that it's all up to scratch and is what they want. And then after that, it goes into the game if they like
Sure.
it.
And what they want is, I guess, a little bit subjective, objective, but so they provide you with like some template, right? You can't like make an IO set and make it bright orange. Are their templates very helpful or are they super limiting? Like, I know you have to kind of stay within the confines for the sake of the game. Does that kind of help you and give you direction, or would you prefer it to be a little more loose and open-ended?
The direction is very, very needed and it's really fun. I really like having art style constraints. Working in the games industry for a while, you just get used to it. It's very, I don't know, it helps a lot when you're designing an idea, to say do it within this box instead of doing it within this giant open plane that you just have no idea. But they've been a bit more relaxed with, well, there was a time when they were way more relaxed than they are now, and slowly they're starting to sort out what they want with their items and being a bit more consistent with the feedback, and we're kind of getting an idea of what they look for now, which is really good.
Sure. That's great. So when you do make one and it makes the workshop, it gets voted up. Valve takes a look at it. They say, "We love this. It's going in the game." Does that manifest itself in, like, I guess current day that is out? Because you can't buy things individually. Does that go into like a treasure as part of a bundle, or what does it look like to customers?
So there's a couple of ways that Valve can sell it on the store. They can bundle it with like a package. Say if you buy these like this bundle, you get everything in the bundle. So that was the Polycount bundle. That was like a $70 trove that you could buy, and you got every single item inside it. Then there is the single items that just release on the store. Usually those are like wards or couriers these days, or music packs. So you can just buy those directly from Valve Store. And then you've got the treasure caches that spit out a random set whenever you open it.
Yep, that's the way most games are going these days, it seems like. And so if your artwork does make it through, it makes it into one of these cases and someone opens it, they paid $3, $5, whatever it might be. The workshop artists used to get, like, let's say it was $10, like they used to give $2.50 to all the artists split amongst themselves, but they recently have that, right? Or I don't know about recently, but that's now, are the economics that 12.5% goes to the artists?
Yes, yep.
Okay.
That's usually what I think. Well, let's see. Yeah, because they changed to 12.5% I think last year. Because of the amount of work Valve artists need to put in to adding particle effects and adding the sets to the game. You might think it's like super easy, right? But game dev is never easy, and the tools that the developers have to use are quite tricky and it takes a lot of time. So instead of making new content, they have to put in workshop content. It actually does take up a lot of time for them. So in light of that, I think they decided to change the percentage so that to compensate.
Sure. So on the surface, excuse me. So on the surface, it may seem like, well, they were giving 25%, now they're giving half. That's greedy, but you think it's justified because they're spending so much more time and resources on their end, kind of taking your artwork and then making it, like you said, adding particle effects and things for the game. So you're pretty, like, it's still pretty reasonable rev share, and you guys as artists are okay with it.
We still, like, if we get a set in the game, it still covers us for the month. It's just that might not get a set in every month, so it's really hard after like 2 or 3 months. And you just start going, oh, I need another set in the game, otherwise I'm gonna go back to doing outsourcing. So
Yep, I gotcha. So is there like a ratio of, like, do you end up making 10 things and one makes it in, or are you making like two things and one makes it in? Like, I know certain artists probably get more than others. Like, what is kind of the ratio of work you have to produce versus work that actually pays you?
Okay, so it's like rolling a dice, but the dice that they give you is like it could be a D20 or it could be a D4, and then you don't know which one you're rolling, and then it's and when you roll it, you don't see the answer. So
So you have no idea.
that's what it's like.
So you can make three sets and get them all in. You can make 10 that are equally as good and none of them get in. That is tough.
Classic.
Yep.
And then when you put them in the workshop, and after like 3 months, you're like, Valve, hello? And Valve just doesn't say anything about them. So you got 10 sets on the workshop just sitting there, and you're just like,
Yeah,
are they good? Are they bad? Do you like them?
they're pretty good at not communicating, unfortunately.
So,
They make great products, but not the best communicators. So there's RNG in the game. There's also RNG for your job. That's not.
it's like playing Chaos Knight
Yep.
on roids. It's really great. It does make it interesting. I don't mind it so much.
Sure.
It's fun. I'm pretty relaxed with everything, but I'm also in a pretty comfortable position. I also have backup if backup finances and career options and things I can do to get extra money. So it's not really that much pressure on me, but it is a lot of pressure on those who aren't as financially stable, who try and do this full time, who like find it hard to get outsourcing work at the drop of a hat kind of thing. So I don't know. It's very hard to schedule around, and it's very hard to like plan around. So for them, for like most people in the workshop, this is extremely frustrating. But
I can only imagine. And you mentioned that you made a set for Envy. Like, does that mean you made a set inspired by him, a set worn by him, a set where it's sold, he gets part of the money? Like, what does making a pro set mean?
I love making pro sets. There's because I watch a lot of pro Dota and I'm pretty close with a lot of the players in the scene. I don't know how, but I just seem to go to LANs and they're like, "Oh, hey," and we like hang out and stuff. So once I started like hanging out with players and well, it all started in 2013 when the pro scene it didn't pay out that much money and unless you were like winning TI, like back in 2018, 2013, only the top 8 got paid at TI and then the rest just got nothing. Just thanks for being here kind of thing. So I was like, damn, that must really suck for a pro player. Like imagine playing, working your ass off like 16 hours a day, playing Dota all the time, and then going to a tournament and because you didn't get the top 3 or the top 6, you just get no money. And then you do that like 6 times a year and you're just living off sponsors. So I was like, man, pro players should like get something for their brand name because they do so much for the Dota 2 community and promoting Dota. So a bunch of us at 20 TI3, we decided to start doing pro player sets and that's where the idea came from. So we make a set with a pro player. So we sit down with the pro, we talk to them what they want, what hero they want, what ideas they might have, and then we try and make a set for them based on them and their ideas. And then we release the set, Valve puts it in the store, and the split to the pro player comes out of our pocket. So we give the pro player like 20 to 30% of our earnings through
Nice.
the split, and then they get to make some money and promote the set, and hopefully everything goes well.
Yeah, that's super cool. Are there any pros that you would love to work with and haven't? Like, we are fairly well connected in the scene as well. So, if there's a certain person out there that you would love to work with, we could maybe make the intro.
Well, most of my like I have a huge backlog of people asking me for sets. So the next one I'll probably be working on is the two guys from VP, Solo and Lil, because
Nice.
every TI, Solo's like, "Anuxi, where is my disruptor set? I want my disruptor." I'm like, "Oh my God, ask me next year." And then like every year, so I'm
That's
like,
great. So
my
you
friend
have
who
plenty of
I.
people wanting work and you just can't keep up.
Yeah, I'm pretty slow these days. So, but I teamed up with my friend who lives down the street now. So her name's Stephanie as well. And we've teamed up and we're starting to make sets together because it's faster. She does all the boring stuff that I hate doing, that like should only take me a day to do, but because I hate it, it takes me like 4 days.
Sure.
So she's doing it for me, and then I can relax and be more comfortable just doing the bits that I really like.
Sure.
So she loves VP because she watches as much Pro Dota as I do. Actually, she's worse. She stays up till like 4 o'clock in the morning watching Pro Dota. And I'm like, "Where have you been?" She's like, "Oh, I woke up at 1 because I was watching VP." And I was like, "Oh, okay." She loves VP.
Nice.
So when I told her, I said, "Oh, Solo wants a set." She's like, "Oh my God."
That's
Oh my God.
fantastic. It's fun being fans, but then also being involved in the scene.
Yeah, it's really fun.
So you
So.
said like so you said sometimes it should take you a day, it takes you four, like to make, obviously making an entire set's different than individual piece, but like how many hours goes into making something? I have no concept of this. I don't know if it's 2, 10, 50, 100, like how much time goes into making one of your best sets?
Four weeks roughly.
Okay,
For
got it.
the PA set was like 8 weeks because the I made it. Like I did all the design and stuff. I did like a whole design and MB was like, "I don't like it," so I had to like redo it. And then I redid it again. He's like, "Look, I don't like the hair," and so I was like, "Oh shit, I gotta go do the hair again." So it was a lot of reworking because MB's really picky and I really respect him for that. He's like the kind of guy that he knows what he likes and he
Sure.
knows what he wants. So if I can just nail that, I know I've done like a really good job. And
Right.
when he said he loved, he like saw it in game. He's like, "I love it." I'm like, "Oh my God, I did
Mission
it! I did it!"
accomplished.
That's like the biggest high five.
That is awesome.
Working with Sing Thing actually was super fun. So I did his Beaver Knight courier, and I sent him the files. Like I usually don't do this, but I sent Sing the files. And I said, "This is how you put it in the game, and I want you to test it out." And he did it on stream, and we recorded it and we made a video out of it, but he was so excited. He was like, oh, wow. He was like, you could hear the happiness in his voice. I was like, oh, it's just, that's the best.
That
Like,
is the best.
it was
That's
so
better than
good.
some of the money in the payoff when you actually just get to have experiences with
Yeah.
people in the scene. That is
Yeah, it's
awesome.
just really nice to see how people react to your art. I think is the most exciting thing. It's very, very rewarding.
Absolutely. And so you're obviously a Dota fan. You make Dota items. Have you ever looked at other games like Counter-Strike and even things outside of Valve, or you just love Dota and there's no other games to even consider?
I did look at Counter-Strike because I was told that it makes ridiculous money. So I was like, I could probably use this to supplement my income, right? And I looked at it and I was just like, I really don't like I just find doing the art style boring. I don't really interested in Counter-Strike. I did try and play it for a bit, but I was just like, eh, I'd rather play Dota. And it was just like this whole thing where it just didn't sit well with me. So I was like, look, I'm not gonna do this just for the money, because if I do it just for the money, it won't be very good.
Exactly
Like,
right. If you're passionate about it and you love it, it's going to show in your work. And if you're just doing it for the
yeah.
money, it's going to be terrible.
Yeah, it definitely shows. So I was like, look, I could make a lot of money from it, and because I have like a huge following on the workshop, I could get lots of votes and all this stuff, but I was like, I just don't enjoy it, and I don't think it'd be fair to Counter-Strike if I got stuff in and it wasn't good. Like, there are so many people who love Counter-Strike and who are really good at doing that kind of thing, and they're making good money off it. So all about more power to them.
Yep, for sure. So the next sets we can hopefully expect to see in the workshop from you would be some Virtus Pro sets.
Yeah, probably. So I'm gonna finish off my Legion Commander set that I'm working on with stuff that we were doing before the Frostivus got announced. So we just finished up Frostivus deadline, which was on November 20th. We did an OG set and a Toby 1 Drow set
Nice.
in the Frostivus theme. So that was really fun. I worked with Ebony, because I've been friends with Ebony since 2013, because I was like a huge Fnatic EU supporter. And I met Ebony because she was obviously with Tal, and we were talking, and whenever we go to events together, we'd hang out, or like whenever there was a Fnatic game and it was like super close, we'd be messaging each other going, "Ah, oh, I can't handle it."
That's
So
great.
we got to work together on a set for her for OG, and I got to work with her, and it was really fun. So
Awesome.
those were the two last ones that I did, and then hopefully the Legion Commander set will be next whenever I've finished my break, which it should be this week. And then after that, yeah, try and get in touch with Solo. I'll have to DM him again on Twitter. I'm like, stop holidaying and driving your Mercedes.
No kidding.
Talk to me about this.
We'll definitely keep an eye out for your upcoming sets, and assuming they're good, you'll have our vote.
Ah, awesome. Thanks. Don't vote if it's not
We
good.
won't. No way. So
Thank
for
you.
fan people that are fans of your work, they can follow you in the workshop. Where else are you active on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram? Where else can people find out more about you?
Twitter's good if you're really into just looking at art. I have an art station. They all use the same handle, Anaximandr. I have, yeah, that's about it. I don't like Facebook, so I don't really post there that much.
Sure.
And I don't do Instagram. It's just, yeah, Twitter. Twitter for everything. Twitter's the bomb.
Cool. Well, yeah, if you guys are into workshop stuff, Dota, definitely check out her Twitter. We will link it here. And I really appreciate your time.
Oh, no worries. Thank you.
Cool. Have a good evening, or actually morning where you are.
Yes, it's very early morning.
All
It's a
right. Well,
good day.
enjoy your Australian weekend.
I will. Thank you so much.
Yep. Thanks. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.